He's not a very serious procedure. I mean, he's a suspected lady, he's dead.
Il a 24, le chauffeur, non, je parle du chauffeur. Mais il a aussi, s'il a 20 années, je veux dire.
Sir,
il était parfait.
Excuse me. Till now, we were listening to you, but we're representing an American network. Mm-hmm. And could we also have a few words in English with you about this story that happened to your son this morning? Well, I think we better start from the beginning. What time did you get the call that was advising you that your son at 8:15? And what happened at your apartment?
Well, I mean, I'll have to say, repeat it, but very, very scantily. He asked me to collect the money quickly. Is this thing working?
Yes, it is.
And come myself personally as quickly as possible to his, myself in person to his flat. So it was rather obvious what was up, that there was a gunman involved, because otherwise he would have given better explanations. He said, don't ask me any questions and do what I'm asking you. He's a sensible, quiet type of fellow, so I mean, it's quite clear that something was very much up. So I went to the bank. It took a long time to collect the money because you haven't got that amount. It had to be recovered from the Bank de France. It took a long time. And in the meantime, I warned the police. But I warned at the top because I didn't want some bloody fool to come with his big boots and make a noise which would produce the reaction of the gunman just shooting everyone. So I talked to someone high enough to react like any of us would want to, which he did.
And at what time did the police come in on the scene?
They came in with me. They were hidden when I went in.
How were you able to raise so much money, sir, so quickly?
Well, a bank goes to the Bank of France, can take any amount of money. It's professional.
You went to the Bank of France?
But the cashier of my bank went to the Bank of France. It's a routine job to collect cash. No questions asked. I mean, one doesn't. It's professional, sir.
But how did this gunman get into your apartment in Paris?
Into your apartment.
Into...
We don't live together. He lives with his mother.
Into your son's apartment, yes, right. David Rothschild.
That's right.
Well, he just came, rang at the bell, and asked to see me, and as one is not usually prepared for such kind of scene, there's no reason.
Who was in the apartment. And then finally, we got into my car with the chauffeur, and we were just the three of us. The chauffeur, I was sitting next to the chauffeur at the gunman's request, and he was sitting behind.
And where was your son during that time?
He stayed in the flat, it was finished, he was over.
Could you tell us about the patch on your eye, sir?
No, it's because when the police attacked the car to capture him, they smashed the glass, and the flying glass just cut my eye, that's all. So it looks very glamorous, but it's only a very, very, very minor thing.
And what kind of a person will you qualify this person who ransomed your son?
Paranoia, if I may answer. Something like that.
Something odd.
He was
intelligent.
He was a young 24, man.
24.
And do you know anything about him?
No.
Did he say anything
on
the car drive?
No,
to you?
No. Only arguing about how he'd get away and me trying to give him ideas to get rid of him.
Did you think the police that he would shoot you when the police swung the car off the road?
Well, I knew the police were doing a proper job. In other words, trying to capture him when they thought they wouldn't endanger my own safety. And it's only after we'd been riding up and down for the best of half an hour, 3 miles an hour, that they got orders to not to let it go on forever. It would be worse than to attack.
This ever happened in your family before, sir?
Not that I remember.
Could you finally tell me? Hmm? Could you tell me where you come in the ranking of the world's rich men?
Where what?
Where you come in the ranking of the world's rich men?
Way down the list. So much lower than anyone would ever believe that I would. If I told you, although I don't know the figure, you wouldn't believe it.
You don't believe there are any political kidnapping?
Well, it's not a kidnapping. He wanted the money.
No.
But there's no reason to believe it. I mean, there's no evidence pointing that way. If something turns out of it, it seems highly improbable.
No,
his behavior makes it very improbable.
This young man,
Voilà, monsieur.
Mais qu'est-ce que j'ai pu manquer?
Non, j'ai raconté le coup de téléphone de mon fils, le fait que c'était long de trouver l'argent.
C'est pas votre
but, non, je l'ai envoyé. Ah, oui, c'est
vrai. Alors, dès que vous avez eu le coup de téléphone de votre fils.
Je me suis habillé, j'étais à mon bureau, j'ai fait le nécessaire pour trouver la somme, ce qui voulait dire envoyer quelqu'un à la Banque de France.
In a hole in my carpet, which was luckily it wasn't pointing towards me. And this was the major event
and
during the 2 hours where I spent with him.
When you telephoned your father for the ransom money, mm-hmm. how did you get across to him that you were in this sort of predicament?
Well, you know, I'm not the kind who does jokes of that sort early in the morning. So when I asked him to come with 2 million, he obviously saw something was wrong. And I told him that he couldn't ask me any questions and he should come quickly with 2 million in cash.